Hi, I'm Emma Jenkins. I'm a specialist in contract law, and I've been brought in to work as your agent. I'll be working to get you the best deal in the boardroom, which means you need to do the best possible job out there on the circuit. When you get new contract offers, either from new teams or an amendment to your existing offer, it'll come through me. I'll also keep you up to date on discussions behind the scenes to change your terms or any specific goals that the team has set for you. If a contract offer does come through, I'll present to you the available offers and then you can make the call. I assume that all sounds fine. Well then, good luck this season and I'll catch you later.
Welcome to Melbourne, where the practice session is about to start for this weekend's Australian Grand Prix. The pre-race talking.
We're going to be logging some extra data during this session. Nothing you need to worry about, but as we have some new parts, we'll just confirm they're performing to spec.
Thank you.
conditions should remain dry. We will keep you informed of any changes to the weather. We'll be right back. scraps of fuel remaining.
Quick look at the classification at the end of the session then. Here are your top three.
Good to meet you at last. My name's Chris, and I'll be working with you as your Chief of Vehicle Development. It'll be my job to get your feedback as a driver and to direct our upgrade design in the areas that you feel are most lacking. At each Grand Prix, we can run a series of practice programs and log the performance of the car as you drive it at its limit. This gives us data that we can utilize to develop various performance improvements. In order for me to know which upgrades to prioritize, I'll need you to select a development area that you'd like us to focus on. And you can do that in the R&D section of your laptop. Anyway, that's all for now. But I'll keep you up to date, okay? I'll see you soon.
As all the cars are now over the line, your top three again are... An interesting practice session there, then. Let's remind ourselves of the top.
Hey, looks like you've got a bit of rivalry going on out there. This is good. Gets people talking about you. Just make sure you outperform them, okay?
Welcome to Melbourne, where qualifying for the Australian Grand Prix should be getting... Wind down from the excitement of qualifying, here's a look at your top three. A Mercedes, Hamilton, and... They say that even a second is an eternity in Formula One, so going four winter months with no race. So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. It's Mercedes in pole position then, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we...
GPS is now enabled and will be available to use when you are within 1 second of the car ahead in the DRS zone.
Seconds.
this lap, and remember the speed limit. We'll be penalized if we exceed it. Keep that in mind as you approach.
Fuel remaining.
race.
Another fantastic victory for the Silver Arrows. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
The difference was clearly in the strategy. You could tell they'd done a lot of work on the pit wall to really optimise each stint and get the most out of the tyres. And it highlights just how much of a team sport this really is. But credit to the driver as well, though. There's no good having a well-oiled machine behind the scenes without a talented hand on the wheel, of course.
And here are our podium drivers today after that excellent race. They've excelled here, as they so often do, and it's a well-deserved victory. Mercedes, then, are on top today. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. We see a new name at the top of the championship table as we reach the end of the Grand Prix weekend. And now...